Better Living Through Chemistry, Understanding the Science of Sexual Attraction. This is Dr. Paul, author of Boomer Girls, A Boomer Woman's Guide to Men and Dating, and host of Ask Dr. Paul. Yeah, there's a science, there's chemistry, there truly is. We've talked before about the olfactory sense, where that scent of another person is something that attracts you to that person. And there are not a lot of people that you're attracted to, I mean really attracted to. We don't know why that is, but there is that olfactory sense that draws us to another. Even if we use perfume and that perfume wears off, be it male cologne or female perfume, it does attract the other. And it's not just looks alone. This is something that we've discovered not too long ago. We find some of these colognes and perfumes that have pheromones, but that's still different. After you've been with someone sexually and they have this certain scent that they emit, you either like it or you don't like it. And if you like it, you're there. If you don't like it, you're not there. And it truly happens, and I know you know what I'm talking about. So it truly is an issue. It is something that way back, I guess before we were involved with being civilized, we had that, and that instinct is still there. So, yeah, there's a lot to science and sexual attraction, and that's one of the items. There are other items, too. Physical attraction based on the physical outline of the body, both for men and for women, and different people prefer different things. We'll go into that at some other time, but it has to do with people in your childhood who were kind to you and happy with you, and you relate to that type of body because of those issues. This is Dr. Paul. May your fantasies of today be your realities of tomorrow.